Greg, you want to take a look at the app that I'm making?
Sure.
And wait for it.
Oh. I'm not sure what I'm looking at. It says house shopping list, and then there's nothing underneath. Like, who am I shopping with? What items are we buying? Do you have any more data on this?
Well, it's an early prototype.
Okay.
Okay, but I hear what you're saying. It seems like you want more data.
Bingo.
How'd the initial user test go? Did they like it?
Kagure seemed underwhelmed. JP, the users want more data to be shown in the app.
Well, you should give the people what they want.
Yeah.
Implementing a list of list items sounds hard and a bit beyond version 0.1. But we could start by trying to store two pieces of data with a shopping list instead of just the name of the list. We could store the name and the owner. The owner will need to be a dummy value, though, since we don't have any user accounts working.
Well, I have heard that you can convert simple Java objects into Firebase database JSON. So we could make the shopping list an object with two fields and then store it in the database. I'll take a look at it with our developer.
When you're working in Java and storing data, you might find that it'd be really great if you could just save an object to the database. In this case, I bet you'd really like to store a shopping list object, which, let's say, has a name and an owner to start. Now, it is possible in Firebase to make a hash map with a collection of key value pairs, and then you can use that hash map to change your data in Firebase. You can easily forget a key value pair, though, so this is not the recommended way to do it. The expert recommended way to do this is to make a pojo, aka a plain old Java object. And then you can use Firebase's built-in serialization capabilities to both put Java objects into the database and take back out Java objects. To allow the Firebase SDK to do this, our object structure needs to adhere to a few simple rules. And here they are. Let's go ahead and take a look at each of these. The first rule is that every instance variable must match your children's key names in Firebase. When your object goes into Firebase, it's basically going to look like this. You'll have some sort of root node and then a bunch of properties that correspond to member variables of the object. And these keys here need to match the member variable names exactly. Also, the types for all these variables should be Java types that Firebase can handle. And those types are booleans, strings, longs, doubles, lists containing objects that are any of these, maps containing strings and objects that are any of these, and any other Firebase pojos. These two values happen to be strings, so we're all set there. Rule 2, you must have at least an empty constructor in your pojo object. You can make other constructors, and you don't need to use the empty constructor, but it does need to be there. And rule 3 is that you need a public getter method for every member variable. For example, here's a public getter method for owner. It should say get and then the member variable's name in camel case. Okay, so let's do this in the code.